Well, hello there, everyone. Shiki here, and we're going to be talking about the very first anime of the summer 2022 season. Yeah. Now, I actually did not expect to make the first video this soon. I was expecting at least another week, since some shows are basically just starting out. But this particular show just so happened to have two episodes released today. And so, that's why we're talking about it. This show is, of course, My Isekai Life. I gained a second character class and became the strongest sage in the world. Now, if you remember from the promotional video thing we did, if you watched that, I had mentioned that I read the manga for this. Yes, I did. So I know all about this. I know everything. Yeah? I know where it's going. I know what happens. So, needless to say, I was a little caught off guard by the first episode. And I'll get into that in a moment. So first of all, what is this show about? It's about Yuji Sano, this main guy here, who is a black company employee. And for those of you who don't know what a black company employee is, basically they're really shitty companies in Japan that treat their employees like garbage, basically. There's like hella overtime, low wages, basically real, real bad. Anyway, this guy is summoned to another world while finishing up some work at home. His profession in the other world is a monster tamer. It's a job that's basically considered to be one of the worst jobs to become, like an adventurer. However, thanks to some slimes he met, which read several magical books, he gains magical powers and a second profession called Sage. He acquires this overwhelming power, and he, you know, goes around testing his strength and, you know, doing that kind of stuff and whatnot. So it's one of those where the main character gets sent to another world, becomes an adventurer, and does stuff, right? In this particular one, he becomes a tamer who tames monsters, mostly slimes, some other monsters he'll tame along the way and whatnot. But yeah, it's kind of the story. And he just goes around doing stuff. There is a bit of a plot behind it, but it's a little bit of spoilers, so I'm not going to get there yet. So anyway, the first two episodes. Well, the first episode starts off like way deep into the story. Okay. It doesn't even show him arriving on this new world, learning about himself, learning about taming a monster or anything. It just starts out with him killing a monster, and then he goes back to the guild, gives them a bunch of stuff, and then all of a sudden there's like 10,000 monsters showing up to attack the city. I saw this and I was like, did I miss an episode? Is this really not episode one? Maybe they switched episode one and two around. So I looked at episode two and that was even further along, so I was like, huh. All right, let's watch episode one and see what happens. So I watched it. He proceeded along, you know, the same linear path that it would after that particular point. Good stuff. I liked it. What I do not like is this motherfucker's face right here. If you compare it to what it is in the manga, it's really hard to explain, I think. In the manga, he, like, looks more like passive and bored with everything and like tired, you know, I'd say he looks a lot tired. But it's not bad. Also, his hair's not as like sticky uppy as it is in this thing in the manga. It's more like slicked to his head and whatnot. It makes him look a lot cooler. But yeah. Anyway, that's just a little side thing there. So I finished episode one and I was like, what the hell's going on? Because they like show you a bunch of characters, like the slimes, and then there's this dryad girl And you already see that he has like a white wolf with him. And none of these characters are really introduced like very well or how they met. And it's like, what is going on? I even read like the comments of the episode and people were like confused as well. And I was like, okay, I'm not the only one. So I watched episode two. Okay, and episode two picks up where episode one left off. I was thinking maybe they would just do a first episode where it would be a little bit further in to get people's attention. And then they'd go back and be like, okay, so how did this all start? Yada, yada. This is not the case. There is one scene in episode two, however, where he goes to bed and then has like a dream, which is a flashback of how he arrived in the world and met the slimes and got his powers. But that takes like a minute-ish, minute or two maybe. And that's all it is. Like, it doesn't explain anything. It shows him waking up, looking at what a status screen would be, immediately making a monster his, like, slime thing, or his tamed monster. He follows the slime, goes to other people, meets more slimes, tames them, and then they find this, like, book place, and then they read a bunch of books, and he learns a bunch of magic. Essentially, that's what it boils down to. In this, like, 1 to 2 minute span of stuff happening. And then he wakes up and the story continues. And I was like, what the fudge is going on? Very confusing. I did honestly not expect it to be like that. And I'm wondering if what they're going to do is just occasionally sprinkle in flashbacks. But it doesn't make sense because you got to understand, folks. In the manga, when I was reading it, and if I had to equate the things that happened and put them into, like, episodes, episode one would be him, you know, wandering around, figuring out what's doing, waking up in the new world, all that kind of stuff, and then maybe stumbling across the town, right? And then in the town, he's supposed to become an adventurer, which would be episode two. And there's a bunch of other stuff also happening while he's in the town that is touched upon. He doesn't just become an adventurer. There's tests and stuff that happens. And then that occurs. And then after that, there's probably going to be like another episode where he meets that dryad lady. So we're already like three episodes in prior to where the first episode would have taken place. There's a lot of content that they just decided to cut out. And honestly, I don't know what they're doing. If they're really going to cover all that in flashbacks, it just seems weird. Also, watching the opening for the anime, they show like a bunch of people from the beginning town. But if I remember correctly, he never goes back to the beginning town again. So it's like, why are you showing these people? It's hilarious. They might get referenced once or twice, but anyway. anyway. Onto the show itself. I enjoyed the show, but they had this weird thing that they did where they would play music where it does not belong at all. Like, it was really, like, overly hype music, too, when he would just be, like, walking around. Like, the scene where he, like, really did, like, the flashback thing. It's like, kind of shit like that, right? Not exactly, but just to give you guys an example of him just walking down a path and looking at books. And then there's another scene where some people are talking together around a table. And it's like also really intense music. And it's like, this doesn't need to be here. And then it stops for like a couple minutes. And then he does something and then it picks up again, right? As he, you know, does something else. So it's like, I don't understand why they decided to add music in places that it doesn't belong. Especially when there's characters that are talking, and it's like fighting for volume. The talking and the music is like conflicting, so it's like annoying a little bit, right? And don't get me wrong, there are times when, you know, you play the music and people are talking, but usually when the people talk, there's like they're jamming out during a fight, like the music's on full blast. And there's kind of a lull in the fighting where the music goes down in volume. They talk, And then the volume starts picking back up as they resume fighting, right? That's usually how it goes, but this just seems weird. I don't know. I'm really looking forward to this anime, though. So I gotta say, I'm probably gonna continue watching it. 100%, no doubt. So that's my plan. But check it out yourselves. I would definitely say read the manga first, at least up until he reaches the first town. Once he reaches the first town, you can watch the anime and you'll kind of have an idea what's going on. But yeah. Yeah. It was just really weird. Gotta say. Anyway, that's the first one that's come out. I have watched a couple of other first episodes for some shows, and some of them are really good. There's one or two that I'm already feeling I'm probably gonna drop just right off the bat because of one was really weird. One of them I'm not too sure about because it might just devolve into an idol anime. And then after that, there's plenty more coming out. So I look forward to watching them all, baby. And yes, I know we still have Shikamori is not just cute. She's also cool, that anime. But episode 11 came out the day before, I think. Forget when exactly. So we have one more week until we talk about that one. And then we can go from there. But yeah, everyone, thank you all for listening. And look forward to more coverage of the first impressions. Yep. Till next time, everyone. Bye for now.